Yeah, so a common theme of especially like high capacity leaders that I engage is that I just don't have enough time to take care of myself. Like when 24/7, when it's all said and done, that's going to go, which means health goes physically. There's weight gain. There's high blood pressure. There's whatever else going on physically. And there's oftentimes fatigue mentally. Sleep isn't happening well. There's not rest. The body's not replenishing, which means the mind isn't replenishing, which probably means I'm not managing the reality of my emotions really well. And I'm probably not cultivating what I really value and deeply care about. So those are all signals. So what that means is that we've got to like reconstruct our mindset towards self-care and not see it as like this option. Not see it as this like narcissistic self-indulgent thing I do, but it's actually critical as eating food is to my existence. So there's a mind shift. We kind of have to understand how like I cannot not do these things. So what are those things? Those things in that book, The Power of Full Engagement, goes deeper sort of into the science of this, but in the powerful engagement, they talk about physical, mental, emotional, spiritual replenishers are investments. And they don't have to be mass amounts of time. They can be thoughtfully weaved through my daily life from morning till night. In life planning, we say intellectual instead of mental. So we have the acrostic PIES, P-I-E-S, physical, intellectual, emotional, spiritual. The physical is the easy one. It's like, it's, you know, people work out, they exercise. But so the science behind that is that, you know, there's actually science that says, especially there's a tipping point when you turn 50, that if you don't get your heart rate up to 85% of its maximum capacity for 30 to 45 minutes, four times a week, the cellular structure in your human body begins to like go down. But if you do that, like four to five times a week, you actually rebuild cellular structure. So now when I work out, it's not a waste of time. It's like I'm doing this so that I have physical stamina and energy to do other things I want to do. Now I can double up. I can listen to podcasts, audiobooks. I have 200 hours of Tom Patterson on my phone. Or sometimes it's music or nothing. You know, but so in those cases, I'm also not just replenishing physically, but I'm replenishing mentally or intellectually. Like I need to have input of good thinking from other people. And that replenishes and stirs up my creative intellectual juices and energy, right? If I go long periods of time without input, I stagnate mentally and intellectually. And on the emotional side, you know, I've learned from like Julia Cameron, have you read the book, The Artist's Way?
No.
It's sold millions of copies. And a lot of artists and like music, lyrical writers, but even like people in the sciences and in business leadership, she has a practice called morning pages. And you first thing you do when you wake up, it's not journaling. It's like brain drain on paper. You write longhand three pages of whatever is in you. It can be emotional, like just dumping. It can be creative thoughts. It can be ordering your day. It can be writing letters to a child or a spouse, whatever. Whatever is in you gets out. And it's like you're skimming the dross off your brain when you wake up. And for me, that has helped me like deal with my emotional realities and all that's going on inside of me. And then on the spiritual side, that's different for everyone. But in their book, The Power of Full Engagement, they define the spiritual as like the hub or the center within our being where our core values and beliefs reside. And those need to be replenished as well. And those can be done through certainly religious practice if people have that. It can be done through meditation. It can be done through reflection. It can be done through different readings of the ancients. Ancient wisdom, stuff like that. So, you know, when we build the replenishment cycle like we did with you, I'm just simply, again, Socratically asking you questions like, what are some things, practices that you've done in the past that you want to maybe restart or keep doing, things you've always thought you'd like to try that would be replenishing that we need to make visible. And then some things, other things out there that are good ideas that maybe you want to dabble in to see if they really do replenish. The point is this, it doesn't have to be a long list of stuff, like 3, 4, maybe 5 things that I can integrate into the rhythm of my weekly life. That if I take enough time, and it doesn't have to be a lot of time, but it has to be strategic, carved out time where I am, even if I'm raising kids and, you know, and young married and busy, I can take these short pauses in my daily and weekly rhythm.
Subscribe to Outliers with Daniel Scrivener now in Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you like to listen to podcasts. Be the first to hear about new episodes and receive exclusive content by joining our newsletter at outliers.fm. I can't wait to help you level up and live your best life.